From St. Paul and the historic Hamm Building, it's the Haberdasher's Couch, starring Heimie along with Dorsett. I'm inviting you to join Heimie and his guest, George Kulczycki, the man behind the bags. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Heimie!
Hey! Wow! I haven't seen a crowd like this since, well, 4 months ago. I tell you what, things have changed, but we have not. Welcome to another show, the Haberdasher's Couch, where you don't have to pay somebody to listen to you. I tell you what, where's my co-host, my sidekick, this week? How long you been in showbiz, man?
Day and a half
is right. I tell you what, Keith, you know, I was walking across the street on the way to the studio here.
Yeah.
Some guy comes whizzing by on his bike.
One of those bike path guys?
One of those bike path guys. Now, we don't got nothing against bike path guys. But you know what I hollered out to him? I said, hey, buddy, do you know the difference between a well-dressed man on a bicycle and a guy on a, what's that called?
A unicycle.
A unicycle. It's a tire. A tire. Boom. I tell you what. Hey, we got a big, big show for you. We're going to do this. We're going to take you first upstairs to the gun library where Keith and I are going to do a little chat.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. And then what we're going to do, Keith, is we're going to go back downstairs in the sub-basement where we're going to talk to George Kulczycki, the bag man.
Oh, the bag
man. Not the bag man from Jersey. But the bag man.
Great music.
Same call. That's right. We'll see you soon. You deserve it.
Oh, hi. There's lots of reasons to say why. I say, why not? Why not indulge at Hiemies?
Good afternoon, and I bet you're wondering what we're doing in the gun libraries.
Oh, am I.
It's another episode of the Haberdasher's Couch, where you don't have to pay somebody to tell them how you feel.
And I'm missing my couch.
So, check this out. We have a leather bag manufacturing facility right here in the Hamm Building. We actually make our own goods. So, what we did today is we put together a collection. Can you grab that briefcase?
Yes.
So Keith actually carries one of our bags. I carry our bags. They are exceptional. What we did is we put together a travel collection, and we've got a dob kit.
Yep.
We've got a travel bag to put your computer in, and then we actually have a place to put your clothes. Now, it's a good time to travel. People are traveling, are camping, are moving around, getting ready for hunting season, right? Getting ready to go back to school or back to work. We got exactly what you need, and what we're going to do, Keith?
Yes.
We're going to take everybody downstairs right now and show them how we do it. The leather bag and canvas leather manufacturing here at Hiemies Haberdashers.
And can I offer, now this is really probably not authorized, and I'm kind of bad boy.
You have a badge, go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. So can I offer $100 of a bag?
Yeah, are you willing to do that?
I'm more than willing to do that.
Well, what he's trying to say is there's big savings. You got to come see us. Check these bags out. Let's go downstairs and say hi to George.
Man.
So.
Lucky I didn't have to comb my hair.
You didn't get much of comb.
Hey, you just a lot there.
That's another thing,
what
too. Keith just got his haircut. This is another episode of Elevator Talk.
Yeah, Elevator Talk.
It's a lot like Couch Talk, but only in an elevator.
Hair's lowered.
Keith got his hair cut today at Hiemies Haberdashery, too. We also cut hair, do shaves,
yep.
And he got a real tight haircut
Took
today.
Took 3 days off of my age.
That's right, you're a bit lighter, too.
I look 3 days younger. That's what I think. Hello. How are you?
We're deep down in the catacombs of the Hamm Building. We're about to sneak up on George, and he's gonna show us how he makes the bags. I hope he's prepared
for this storm, Hamm Building.
Come on.
Hey, Georgie.
Is he even here? I have to make sure he's here.
Camera's on.
Hey, you got clothes on? Oh, he's decent.
Look who's here.
Rats.
Everybody, I want you to take a look at the manufacturing facility. It's quite the space. We've got all of our leather cutters, all our leather sewers, everything that we need to do to make bags.
George,
come
on over. Awesome.
Aren't they good?
Those are awesome.
Come on over, George.
All right, I got to put my apron back.
I have an apron on.
It's a wonderful day in the neighborhood.
Who's it again? Me?
A wonderful day in the neighborhood.
Who's it again?
Won't you be mine?
I'm gonna put my apron on.
Won't you be mine?
So anyway, George has been making bags for us for
years.
He's a master craftsman, and he does pattern making, die cutting, sewing, double needle, single needle, whatever you need, George does.
And he has the best music in the city.
Yeah, maybe we should go
come down here. The music is, man, the man has more soul than James Brown.
So, George, give a little overview of the shop and then just talk about your process.
Okay. This is the leather where it starts. And we have two kinds of leathers. We have, by weight, 8-ounce leather that we do all our strapping, and the 3-ounce leather, boot leather, that we do almost all of our outside exterior work on the bags. And that's all stocked here.
St. James of London Shave Cream. Excellent glide and cushion for a close, more comfortable shave. St. James of London, available exclusively at Hiemies.
Handgun case.
And George also looked like he clearly cuts hair. Is that the clippers you just used on my hair?
This is the clipper that I used.
He used that on Keith earlier this morning.
So that's done to cut around this edge, and we just decided to try a smaller handgun case. We make some other cases for guns, mostly shotguns, and we make another one that's for long revolver type pistols that Anthony's
so what you're with. Telling me, George, is you take a flat piece of material you turn it into a three-dimensional functioning product.
Yep.
Right here down in the catacombs of the Hamm Building.
The fleece comes like this, but anyway, we get it from the shelf, it goes to the cutting table, gets cut, and then it goes to any one of the different sewing machines that you can see back.
So you could say that we've got briefcases, travel luggage bags, and things that go inside those bags to keep you organized.
And can I talk about my favorite bag?
Yours is the roll top.
The roll top. Please, let's just get that it. Is it. You have to own this thing.
Tell them why do you like it, Keith?
Because it carries a lot. It's hands-free. It's secure. It's just a wonderful bag. It traveled. Overseas. This thing here, I put 7 suits in when I went to Atlanta to show a customer suits. This is really it's outstanding. The whole family can use it. It's rugged. It can be used up north. It can be used outside. It can be used professionally. I've actually put a foam in it for a laptop.
Right.
I just love this thing. It's just awesome.
Yeah. I tell you, so what we got is we've got basically, multiple designs that fit many different forms and function. Master Craftsman George Kulczycki is here. With knowledge for you, if you want to come down, check us out. We'd surely appreciate it. Keith, you have anything to add to this?
I don't know why George got all serious on
us. Who turned that hair?
He's usually smiling. I don't know
he's
why. He had to get all posed out and next to the camera. He's looking at the camera all howdy. That's more than George we know.
That's all right. I'll tell you what, next week we're going to have some more stuff for you from the Haberdashers Couch. It's Keith and I signing out for this week. I hope you have a good weekend. We'll see you next week.
Weekend. We'll see you guys. Love you.
Thanks for tuning in.
Love you.